Hey, Mom, what do 16-year-olds care about?
When I was 16, all I cared about was smashing the patriarchy and burning it all down.
Oh, my God.
Girls constitute a revolution.
Amy, this movie is in part sort of about women learning to, like, recognize their anger and, like, express it and sort of, like, grow from it. Like, that it's okay, especially when you're young, to be angry and to be, like, feel like there's been an injustice. How does that sort of message speak to you? And, like, where did you identify with this movie?
Thank you for bringing that up. You're the first person to talk about this, actually, the idea of female anger, because it's a very complicated subject and one that we have distorted, fetishized, undervalued, and also culturally, racially, anger can be used as a way to make change, and it can also be used as a weapon. It's really complicated. But from a very basic level, emotional level, young girls often are not encouraged to find out what they're angry about. They aren't often, there isn't a lot of modeling sometimes and how to, like, really express your anger in a healthy and productive way. And I'm really drawn to watching women, young women of all ages, figure out their relationship with anger, because I think it's really still an undiscovered aspect of storytelling. So yeah, we were saying that this is like a coming of age movie, and we really wanted the women in this film to be able to get in touch with that. Because when you're in touch with that, you're in your body, you can be very powerful, and you can use that as fuel.
Speaking of, I have been on, like, the Kathleen Hanna Riot Girl zine train for like 25 years. So I saw this trailer, I'm like, is this movie made for me? And then I read in the press notes that, she was, like, involved in this, like, she kind of helped by getting some songs to the movie. Can you talk about how you worked with Kathleen?
Oh, man. I'm a huge Kathleen fan. And, also Kathleen and Adam are a couple. I mean, they're, like, the coolest couple ever. She was so gracious in letting us use her music. And, you know, to be clear, and this is certainly not a story about that movement or about that music or the world of that music, but what it does do is music is sometimes a way in to an experience. And I think it's always really interesting that the songs that mean something to you are going to mean something different to someone else when they hear it. Not only are they not going to associate the same time and age when they heard it, but they're just coming with a whole new set of experiences. So Kathleen's music was a connector between my character, Lisa, and her daughter, Vivian. Vivian kind of listens to that music to kind of figure out what is it that inspired her mom. And then what we try to do in the film is include artists who organically kind of fit that vibe and who are, Black and brown artists who are taking what was started by Kathleen and her group and then, like, deconstructing it, making it their own.
I have this written down as, like, best fuck shit up song. Like, sometimes when you just, like, want to, like, do, you know, punch something, I listen to Bikini Kill. Do you have a song that comes to mind?
What I said earlier was Meredith Brooks' Bitch, where she's just talking about everything, like, all the contradictions within herself and how they all exist and are all real, and how she's everything. And it's kind of like a celebration and declaration. I love that song. I love that song. I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child,
I'm a mother, I'm a sinner, I'm a saint. When I was a really angry teenager, it was always I'm Not Okay by My Chemical Romance. I'm not okay. Because it's all about being like, this is who I am. No, I'm not okay with the way things are. I don't know. I loved it. I loved it. Made me happy to be me.
Nobody does anything. Nobody listens to us. Revolution, baby.